Well, howdy, comic book pods. Welcome to Nighttiger Comics, and tonight we's going to show some Western good girl comics for my collection, and I got a special guest, so let's go. Welcome back, Comic Book Pods. Before we bring on our guest, I want to let everyone know that this Jambo Comics, a great guy, is actually the YouTuber that got me into the Western good girl genre. And he may not have known it, but watching his videos, I got inspired to go down and hunt these gorgeous covers that he's been showing. So, with no more further introduction, let's bring him on. Jambo, what's going on?
Howdy, y'all. Just glad to be on here tonight and hanging out with the Nighttiger Comics. Very glad to be on.
All right. So let's I want to ask you a few questions before we kind of show some stuff, because I'm curious. I'm like an analytic collector. I want to know how things work, tick, the history and all that, the background. So for me, I know that I have I set kind of parameters on what I consider the Western good girl comic book, because there are the Western romance, and then there's other Westerns out there that have girls on them. Do you have do you define the genre for yourself? Do you have do you put your books in a specific area, or how do you do it?
I kind of keep them together, the good girl kind of Westerns. I kind of keep those together. And how I define that is, if I look at the cover of a comic and the first thing that attracts my attention is the girl, that's a good girl comic.
Oh, okay. Okay. Comic. I didn't have thought about that. That's definitely, yeah, that's a good way to spot it.
I mean, hey, that's what I go for right there.
you ever just see that one book and you're like, all thought, I gotta have it. It's just your first thought. I gotta have it.
Too many times, too much, and too many times on eBay, and lots of dollars later. Yes.
All right. So let's make your introductions, because we got a lot of the family members in. Whoops, I lost my. We got a lot of the family members in here. So we got Black Box, Silver, and Bronze. Welcome, Joe. We got Matthew Brasile. I don't know him, but welcome to the show.
Welcome, sir.
Yeah, we'll hope to see more of you and hear from you. We got Mastodon Comics and Music. He's been putting out some videos lately. We got Jerry the Jitterbug. Just got a Golden Age book unboxed. Metarog's got his 5-year celebration coming up after this show. And who else we got here? We have some other. I thought Gratu was here. Mm-hmm. And my computer's messing up. All right. So we're going to get into this, because people came here to see the comics. So I'm going to let you start. Wallace, with one of your top ones, and we'll switch off for a minute, and then we'll do a few in a row.
Okay. Well, let me show you one of the one of the ones that really just knocked my boots off was a good old Frank Frazetta.
Oh, wow. See, that wasn't even on my radar.
Arrow, number 22.
Okay, that's on my radar.
Pretty now. Graphic, yeah, because, I mean, look at this Indian's getting ready. He's got a handful of his baby's hair. And straight arrows bolting in there trying to save the baby. And the beautiful blonde-headed girl there, the damsel, the good girl, trying to save her baby. And yeah, that's one of my favorites because, you know, I'm a big Frank Frazetta guy. I love Frazetta.
Okay.
But one of my first ones that you guys know that I like Jungle Comics and stuff, right?
Oh, yeah.
Jumbo and Jungle and all that good stuff. Well, I mean, if you're into Fiction House, you run into some Rangers.
Oh, yeah. Hey, I think I actually have that one here.
You somewhere. Got this one?
That, yeah.
Throw it up, man. And I think this was a Maurice Whitman cover, and I mean, how could you not enjoy some?
Oh no, I don't have that one. I have this.
There you go. Yeah. Oh, you got a fire hair. Yes.
I'm trying to. Oh, I think I got one issue to go to get the run done.
Oh, awesome. So, yeah, that's great stuff. And I mean, that was one of the first ones. Like I said, I was all into the Jungle stuff, but then started noticing those. And I was like, man, you know, there's a whole nother genre out there. Of
oh, yeah.
Cowboy, good girl stuff.
All right. Let me hit you with one.
Yes.
Oh, by the way, do you know Aaron Carter passed away today?
No.
Nick Carter's little brother. He's 34 years old. They don't know what happened.
Backstreet Boys guy.
His brother. Yeah. His little brother.
Oh, wow. Yeah,
his little brother had a bunch of hits. My little daughters used to listen to him.
Yeah, so my daughter was the big Backstreet Boys.
I'm gonna go with this. So this is Western Thrillers. It's actually a reprint by MS Distributors. They have an ad and it's in here. You could send in $1 and get 11 comics.
Wow!
And they basically reprinted. Fox Comics with the original cover.
Fox.
Or I think a lot of them are actual covers too.
Yeah.
They just changed the lettering and some, there's no price on it. So these are actually numbered at the end of the run, anywhere you go to look at a database.
Wow.
So anytime I can find these, I found this one for 30 and then I found this one recently for 30.
That's great.
And these books are all over the place. This is a high grade book. But they're most of them are wanting 100 at this grade, 150. So it's like the Wild West on eBay.
She's got the red dress in distress there, too.
Yeah. I don't know who does this, do I? It reprints Fox Features number 6 of the run.
Okay.
Not sure who does the cover, but yeah, so there you go.
Super cool, man.
All right. You ready? Hit us up. You ready? Heat us up. Okay. I'm going to throw it into your court. Sonia says, Sonia. Oh, nice one.
Tim Tyler.
There were some
the boy
nice covers boy. In there. They were very subtle.
Yeah.
Oh, so, but yeah, I like them.
It's number 11.
I think I have that one, though.
Saving the damsel there from the rage.
Oh, yeah, dude. Ready? Twinsies? Yeah, yeah.
You got this one, right? All right.
I just bought this. Yeah, I did. It's a high grade. It was $50 with shipping.
Wow.
Another seller. I got another issue.
Of the Tim Tyler?
Stuff. Yeah, that was. I told you I got it for $6, the other issue.
Yeah. You got a great deal, man. I mean,
I'm a hunter. I got to hunt. All right.
Stuff.
Jamie, throw up another one there.
All right.
Tell us about it.
About another Ranger.
Oh, there you go. Man, I just pulled another one up here. Where do we go?
Hiding from the engine.
Uh-huh. That, now, see, I like that cover. Most of the covers she's on aren't done very well. Mm. It's not, it doesn't look very like,
some of them are, and then some of them are not. Most of the ones with Oh, I just said
that. I wonder if Doolin did that cover. It looks really nice. Here, look at this one. Here, look at this one, Pard. Isn't that the same as that cover that you showed?
Yeah.
Isn't she climbing just like that?
Similar. Let me see. Yeah, it's pretty similar, man.
Oh, okay. She's throwing.
She's like swinging at somebody, but it's very similar. I mean, if I do like that, yeah.
I don't know. They did, yeah. It looked a little bit. All right, here we go. All right, I'm going to show one now. Okay, Night Tiger's up. We got Imperious Flex here. We got Jacob Bordowski, Spinner Rack Studios. Oh, I'm putting the link in here. If you have any Western Good Girl comic books from the Golden Age that you want to share, you're welcome to come on the channel and share those with us. So there's the link right there.
Our partner, Spinner.
Gray Man's here. What's up, Gray Man? So we got a full house. We got Levin. Okay, it's my turn.
There you go.
Let me show this one. You know, one of the titles that you really turned me on to that I had no idea was this one. So I searched and searched. Finally found me one for under $30.
Yeah. Yes.
Just a great, great cover. This is a Max Elkin cover, and he inks his own pencils. Wow. Just gorgeous.
Good stuff. Like the mirror behind him there, showing the bad guys.
Right. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Yeah, that's a great cover.
That is good.
All right. We're going to get Jamie up here now. What's up, Pod? Let's see. Ooh, Bronco Bill.
Schomburg. Goodness.
We can see now, it's a subtle depiction that she has all the power because she's holding the keys.
Yeah.
And that's the center of the cover.
And the reins. And yeah,
that's right.
The first thing that catches your attention. So yeah, that's what I look at when I look for good girl art. If my eyes are drawn to that.
Now, Jamie or Jambo, let me ask you this in all seriousness. What is actually in the very center of that cover?
It's the focal point.
Right? Yeah. You think that was meant like that? Because I
haven't. Yeah, probably so.
Metrog's horn swoggled.
Some bondage back there.
All right. Throw us up another one. Throw us up another one. So do you have a years on those on the back? Do you write the year?
Let me see. I think I wrote the year. Yeah, 1949.
Nice.
Alex Schomburg cover.
For me, I consider the 48 to 54, like the good girl era.
There's one from.
Oh, you know, 19- I need that, dude.
Lone Rider.
What number is that?
Number 4.
I need that. I'm getting that. That's a great cover. Well, that's a great cover. I don't know what keeps having my accent.
That's keep right losing it. Ball right there.
Oh man. I'll be saving her.
Yes, sir.
All right. We'll throw it over to me. We'll see what thank I can you, throw buddy. Let's see what I can show here. Okay, so I got a big book. It just actually came like less than an hour ago.
Yes.
And I'm sitting there doing the show, and I'm like, wait a minute, I think that's what I need for tonight. So I just got this in. It's a Timely Annie Oakley number 2. I think it's 1948.
That is sweet.
Oh, 1948. It is 1948.
Very sweet.
I love it. It's just, it's got this like cartoonish style, but it's still very good girlish.
Look how she's turned her whole heel around backwards there.
Oh, yeah. I just see that.
Now. Quite flexible.
And look at her glove, the top of the glove. That looks so cool. I always like that on characters in comics when they have the glove like that. But just a very cool. Look at her gun. It's huge.
Say maybe did that.
So that's the newest one to the Nighttiger collection as of now.
That's mighty fancy.
Thank you very much. Thank you. All right, Jamie. Throw it up.
How about some Barbie Riders.
Oh, yeah. I've kind of toyed with getting that issue quite a few times.
And she's slapping the cow spit out of that fella there, knocking his hat off.
That's abuse. She's abusing that fella. She's brilliant. Well, tarnations.
Tarnations. This is
she's number... like jumping in a rattlesnake.
Number 12.
All right. Barbie Rider.
Barbie.
What a kind of unique name for a book.
I got an Annie. Ooh,
there's Annie.
It's a photo cover.
Now,
not as fancy as yours.
What's she doing? Reading the bullet?
She's looking at that bullet. I think she might be naming it her.
She probably said, this bullet's got your name on it.
She's going to put that into somebody that she's not liking too well, I think. Maybe a feller that's done her wrong.
All these cowpoke are trying to make funny sayings here in the comments. So let's see these funny guys here.
Yes. She's got a...
She's taming the wild stallion. Uh-huh.
Annie Oakley.
All right. Okay, Nighttigers. Going to throw something up on the screen. Now, this book is probably the only one that is out of the genre era, but it is part of the Jesse James, but it has the code, but it's a very killer Kinstner cover.
I would still say that one qualifies, man.
Yeah, that's why I have it. It was from 1956, but I have not seen a good girl Western cover that late in the era this good.
That's nice.
This is another eBay find, just under $30 ship. That's my sweet spot.
Yeah.
I'll go 50, but I really want to go 30. All right, let me do one more. How about we go Range Romances? This is number one from December 1949, Paul Gustafson cover. This book here, I waited about 3 years before one came up for under $50. And this one was 45-42 shipped. It's really cool painted cover. And then I think two has a painted cover and three and four have photo covers.
He's wanting to give her some cowboy love.
I'm telling you. Those are mighty tight fitting jeans on her. All right. Back to my par Jambo Comics.
How about some Wild Bill
paper? Yeah, there's some good ones in there. I got me one in here.
That engine is wrangling that wagon right from under her.
Oh, man. She be in distress. Arts, Boxing Comics, Howdy Cowpoke.
Marshall of the Tombstone City.
That series has some really great covers.
And that's a Sid Shores cover.
Oh, that's why it's good.
So, right fancy.
Rope us up another one, partner.
What about a Durango Kid?
There you go. Oh, that's another one I've toyed with a few times.
And
Sassy girl, she don't want to be carried.
Oh, he's Shanghaiing her.
Oh, he's taking her?
Yeah.
He's taking?
Saving her. Carrying her across the log. That guy's going to shake him off that log, it looks like. Oh,
that's a good one. I need to get that one.
That's number 30. Number 30.
All right. I'll throw it up all to Nighttigers over here. He's wrangling that woman. Dang, you sure you ain't American? All right. What do we got? We got some Chorus Girls. Dead Eye Western, number 12, October 1950. This is from the collection of BWD. Jesse Lynch sent this to me, so shout out to him. I have not been able to find another cover that has dancing hall girls with fishnets.
That's some fancy high stepping they're doing there, too.
You keep your tongue off my books. All right. Oh, yeah, I just picked up a second copy of this. I can't find it though. Redskin number 12.
Ah, I think I've got that one.
Bondage Good Girl cover going over to Waterfalls.
Sweet.
This is from October 1952. Yeah, there you go.
Quite acrobatic there, save that damsel.
I know that engine's quite distracting from the cover. You could remove him altogether, and that'd be a better cover. But seriously, I mean, it would. I mean, he's don't look right to me. Anyway, what do I know? So anyway, we're gonna get back over to Jambo. Let him.
We got the last there. New Mexico on in our chat too. From New Mexico.
Roger said our accents are really good. Nice.
Bronco Bill.
That girl's back in the back going, oh my.
Outside the saloon.
He must have insulted his girl.
Yeah, he did. Not there. I don't think that's a Schomburg.
1949?
You know, I didn't put the date on this one, so I'm going to say yes.
I think that ended in 1949, didn't it? Oh, that is a nice one.
What
number is that? I want that one.
It's got headlights and taillights. It's number 14 from
19. It's got two different taillights.
19 and 50. And yes.
That's a beautiful one.
He's right fancy with that six shooter there. Shot that filler in the arm and shot the gun out of that in his hand there. But that's not what I'm looking at. What are you looking at when you're looking at that?
I'm looking right at that gun. and it leads me right to that bun. Oh, yeah. He really defined her backside a little bit there.
Yes.
All right. Throwing up another one.
All right.
Let's see what you got.
Oh, I'm doing another one?
Yeah.
All right. What about
a nice accelerate? Oh, that's a nice one. Dang, what's she out there in a dress like that for?
Well, I always wondered why she's out in the middle of nowhere with just a nightgown on.
Maybe she was out camping or something. Dang.
So she's falling.
But you know what? It makes for a really good cover.
It does.
He's got a big iron.
Trying to save her. And that dude in the critter mask there is trying to cut the rope.
I'd be like, lady, you're gone already. I'm jumping.
I'm going to make it. Sorry.
That was the series that Ghost Rider was in, right?
Yes, sir. No,
what number was that? Seven? The first appearance of Ghost Rider?
Number 35.
But isn't 7? I think 7 is the first Ghost Rider.
11. Number 11.
11. 11. Yeah. It rhymed. All right. What am I showing? Okay. Redskin again. Number 1, 1950. Hanging cover.
Oh, man. Number 1.
There's actually a British reprint from 1950 of this also.
I like that trade dress on that one. That is fancy, man.
That is really cool. It's from Youthful Magazine. It didn't last very many issues. They had a handful of titles that they published. They were mostly really good, above average.
Yeah, that was above average, definitely.
All right, so where are we at? How about an EC? Everybody wants to see an EC.
Definitely.
Saddle Justice, number 6. This is a Graham Ingalls cover. And it's from May 1949.
That's hard to beat.
You are not going to like how much I paid for this one.
Probably going to make me sad because I would have been probably all over it if I'd seen it.
23 with shipping.
Man.
But, you know, look, it's low grade, but still, it's a very hard book to
find. You're a good hunter, man, I tell you.
It's a hard book to find.
You're a good hunter.
It's a hard one to find. I'm telling you. Okay, I'm going to do one more. Okay, how about another EC?
Let's do it.
This is a Johnny Craig cover.
Sweet. Oh, wow.
Gunfighter, number 11, September, October, 1949. Now, I did pay up a little for this, but still got it really for
purdy.
Way less than what it retails for. I paid $99.99.
That is purdy. Man, I need that in my life.
Oh, I'm hunting these two titles, All the Good Girls Only.
Yeah.
They won a lot for number one of this, but the cover is terrible. Hmm. All right, back to you, partner, you cowpoke. Get off your high horse and get on the ground, show some comic books.
We're in Kentucky, so I'm going to show some Dan'l Boone.
There you go. Oh, I need that. I'm after all the Avon Westerns, Good Girls. Dan'l, that's a good one.
Choking out the Indian there.
Oh, Jamie, I just found one this week. It's one of those IW reprints.
Oh, yeah?
And it reprints one of the Avon Good Girl Western covers. I forget which one. But they have a few of them on eBay, but I forget the title of the thing. I have it in my checkout, but it's really cool. Dude, that's a nice cover.
18.
Who's that?
Durango Kid. Not only is the...
But do you know the artist of the cover?
That's probably... It's got an A there, so I'm going to say Ayers, Dick Ayers, probably.
Oh, okay, yeah. Nice. I love the flames.
Yeah.
Number 16 or 18?
It's on fire.
And that's Magazine Enterprises?
Yes.
So A1, what number is the A1 on it, you know?
No. I'm
testing your skills.
No. Number 18, though.
Of the, you got to write that on the back, brother.
I need to write stuff on the back. I do that sometimes, but
that's why I get all frustrated, because I'll have piles of stuff. I'm like, I got to take care of this, yeah. Bag it, put the info on, then put it away. James is here. What's up, James?
One more. This one's rough.
That's a nice one.
But it's Bronco Beal, and it's a Schomburg cover.
And you probably paid $5 for it.
I didn't pay much for it because it's beat. Number 6.
Hey, at least she's not beat.
No. See what gets your attention there?
I'm telling you, that horse, shadow, right? Makes you think she's wearing underwear. Hey, I lost my accent. What happened?
And he's a kid inside. I know if you look at these covers and you think, wow, he's lucky cowboy, right? Well, he's like a kid inside on these stories and stuff.
Yeah, I did open them and look in there. Mm-hmm. All right, Metarog, you take care. Don't you come back now, you hear? All right, let's get over to the old Nighttiger. What's up, cowpoke? Let's see some cowboy western comic books. How about some Gunsmoke?
Oh, yeah. I like the Gunsmoke one. Nice.
Blazing.
Nice.
Blazing. Heroes of the West.
Hero of the West.
This is number 7, June 1950.
Nice.
I don't know who does the cover. I'm trying to collect all I can out of this title. They're pretty hard to get. They're semi hard to get.
Of the There'll be waves. That one.
What's that?
Is there a backup story of the Masked Marvel in that one?
I believe so. I have not even cracked one open. I have quite a few issues, though.
Yeah, those are cool, man. So cool.
I'm going to show this one. It's my least favorite Good Girl cover. When I got it, I'm like, this girl looks hideous. You ever see those girls that wear that black lip line around their lips?
Yeah. That's not bad. But, yeah, I see what you're saying.
The only thing that makes it cool, it's Golden Age and has a 10-cent price. She kind of looks horrendous. That's 1951 Blazing West by ACG. All right, let me see here, sir. Let me find me another one to show We're gonna do another DS publisher. Breeze Lawson, Sky Sheriff, one shot.
That's cool.
No, I got an amazing. I'll wait and wait until I find the right deal. So this one is usually over 100 or so. And my comic shop had it for like $23 because it was missing centerfold. It is a high grade copy. And when I got it, the centerfold was there. I was like, yeah, ha. That was a big win. So all in was $23. And this is like a
partner. Hell yeah.
But it's, you know, it's a mainstay. It ain't leaving my collection. All right. We're getting back to Jamie. Woo!
How about some more guns?
There you go. I don't have that one.
Number
I
nine.
Need that.
1950.
Now you can see why I said that Jamie inspired me, or Jambo inspired me, to find these books. That is killer. I love it. I love the graphic.
I love the trade dress and everything. Cool. Very cool.
I'm gonna share something I do. It's kind of, who knows how nerdy we get. I have some like nerdy things that I do. Nice. Love it.
19.
Some really nice covers on that series.
Another Alex Schomburg.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
It's kind of like a flow. If you look, follow her body, and then goes to his gun and then up to his face.
Yeah, somebody's taking pot shots at him there while he's trying to get a drink out of the water.
See, an artist who wasn't very good would not have put those pot shots. They really add to the action. Yeah.
This one kind of has the good girl in the background. So.
Oh, nice. Yeah, I see it. Very nice.
And the little girl.
Just a really, really colorful cover. I've seen that one all
Tim
the time. Holton's,
yeah, there's a lot of good colors and covers on these Tim Holt.
I mean, look at the colors. They run all the way off the cover, top to bottom.
Almost like L.B. Cole, some of them.
Yeah. Spinner Rack's in.
That is number...
Hey, guys.
What's up?
I saw you doing Good Girl Western.
Yes, stuff. I thought that I heard the rumor that you wanted to be in, but I didn't have a way to contact you.
Well, I actually emailed you a couple times.
Oh, you did?
Yeah,
I'm sorry. I don't check my email very often.
But I quickly pulled a few things I can show. You might have already shown some of them.
Okay, you're up. But I have a question for both of you. Now, I do this really weird thing when sometimes I'll come in the room, you know, look at my books, and they're like, wow, these are mine. I'll imagine what it's like to see it for the first time. You ever do that with your comic?
Yeah, like, I mean, when I come into the comic room sometimes.
Well, I'm more like if I'm another person and walk in, you know, what would I do? Be blown away by this book.
Sometimes I think about if I were 18 and I were able to come into the future to now and see my collection, you know, what I would think. And
yeah,
I don't think I would have dreamed that I'd have a collection like I have right now. But
you have a nice collection, sir.
So.
Your books
maybe a lot better, but
that's a great segue. Spinnerack. Now, Spinner, is your first name Dave?
Yeah.
Okay, Dave. Spinnerack, yeah. Dave, welcome to the show.
Thanks.
We're glad to have you, and we want to see
all
these books that you got.
Well, first
there time. You go. I need that one. That has a lot of similarities to the Annie Oakley that I showed.
Yeah. The interesting thing about this copy is it belonged to a Johnny Craig.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Yeah, it's got a certificate. I don't know if you can.
Oh, I love that. It's a beautiful certificate, too.
They were somebody, you know, with selling his collection. And but it's a really nice cover. But the problem, if you open it up, the pages are very brown, almost to the brittle point.
Oh. Have you got a chance to at least read it one time?
I haven't read it. No, I
Are you going to take the chance?
No, probably not. I mean, it's pretty.
Oh, there you go. That's a nice one.
The Ranger,
that's one I came close to getting a few times.
Yeah, crazy outfit she's got on.
Is that Doolin?
Well, I don't. Let me see. Should say Frank Charles Sutton, Frank Dole, Lee Elias. Doesn't really indicate who.
Probably Lee Elias.
Lee Elias, Joe
Dillon. Yeah, Lee Elias probably. Nice. I like the thing that I like the design down her leg.
Yeah, that's quite
very nice. Like bolero Spanish.
Yeah,
like the jumpsuit she's got on there.
Yeah.
You know that she would look like the Phantom Lady if she was black.
Yeah.
Oh, that's a nice one, dude. I want that one. I think I've seen that one. I just didn't want to pay the price because that book could be pricey.
Yeah,
that's a good one.
Nice purple dress.
Yes.
And then,
You know, I didn't pull any of my black cats.
Crazy black cat, you know, when they went to Western for a little while. Yeah. But they just kept her in her costume. They didn't change it.
Oh, yeah. I'm glad they did it.
I don't know how many you want me to show before.
Well, let me go. So you can have some for the next round. Oh, thank you, Dave. Dave, you got to talk in your accent, you know, your adopted Southern accent. All right, cowpoke, y'all ready? Here we go. All right. Now, this is a book that I have that you inspired, Dave, for me to get. And I believe you may have this, and you have some high, nice copies, but Flaming Romance or Flaming Western Romances.
Yeah.
Ooh, yeah.
This is number 3 from March 1950. It's LB Cole cover.
Yes.
She's standing in the fire. Or no, he's standing in the fire.
Yeah.
He's saying, you know what really burns my ass?
That fire.
Feet high.
I love how LB Cole added all these little things, like these bars with stars and different little nuances. I just got this, so I've been waiting for this book to come up under $50. So I got this one, $38.50 shipped. Red Arrow.
Oh, that's a nice one,
man.
Number 1.
2.
Now I need to get number 3. Number 2 doesn't have a good girl cover. I don't know why. Red Arrow. They're pretty tough to get.
Yeah, that's
great. I'm just learning about these.
Wow.
Okay, I'll do one more. We'll pass it off over to Jambo. Why don't we do some Western Crime Busters? Now, who's this girl on here? I forget her. You guys probably remember who she is.
Wilma can't
remember
of her the name. West, right?
Who is it?
Is it Wilma of the West?
Is it? It may be. Yeah. Wilma of the West. And this is number 7. Western Crime Busters, October 1951.
That's a right pretty cover.
Right pretty.
It's darn tootin' pretty.
I like that. I like that.
All right, let's see what Cowpoke Jamie got for us.
What about some Pawnee Bill?
Oh, dude, that's a hard book to get.
It's number 1.
As soon as you showed that, I started looking for it. That is, I love that cover. It actually has like a Jack Kirby feel to it.
Yeah.
Like the inking or.
Bat Masterson and White Earp.
Hey, well, doggy. Well, doggy.
And what about some Kit Carson?
Oh, yeah. Hold on.
Fights of Comanche Raiders. There you go.
This is the one that IW reprints on a title, this cover.
Oh, yeah.
And it's blue. Realistic. It's blue in the background.
Okay.
I forget the name of the title.
That'll
okay, back to you.
Or he'd be paying more attention.
I know. She's like, here, drink.
All right, what about some more Bronco Bill?
Very cool. What does she got, a machine gun?
Got
a repeater,
I think.
Yeah, it's a
repeater. He's got his repeater in her hands.
This one is number 15 from 1950, another Alex Schomburg cover.
Nice. Sweet doggies.
I like those Bronco Bills.
All right, we're going over to Dave. Dave, hit us up with your Southern accent.
Right. Well, first of all, I'll get the breening out of the way.
There you go. Well, we call it twinsies on this channel.
Here's another one of those.
That's an unsanctioned. Hold on, that's an unsanctioned breed. Excuse me, everybody. That is a gorgeous cover.
Yes.
I love when you read those. Her waist is so thin she couldn't even swallow food.
Yeah, yeah. And I think it's a Lee Elias cover. So let's see what else. Oh, here we go. Little cowgirl.
Man, I don't have any of those yet. Ranch of the Riddle, send back my love.
She's fretting something awful there, isn't she?
And I'll do one more here and then let you move on.
Oh, nice. Oh, dude, I need to pull mine.
Very nice.
All right, hold that up for a second.
Very nice. That's in good shape, too, man.
Because I forgot I had one of those. All right. Over to Nighttiger. Beautiful book. I need to get that.
Yes.
All right. They're stepping it up, folks. Nighttiger is going to take it up another notch. Here we go. Oh, that's the same book.
Yeah, that's it.
Damn. Twinsies. Kit of the West. Now, I like Kit better than Wilma. West or Wilma West? Dang, he's probably faking it going, yeah, take care of me, woman. Take care of me. All right. Okay, I'm bringing it up. One more notch.
Picking it up a notch.
Hanging cover.
Oh, hanging cover, yeah.
Oh, no.
Damn you, Glare. Get off my screen.
You feel that noose tight around your neck, you know you're in trouble.
There you go. Oh, yeah. That's a dueling cover right there.
That's a right fancy one.
She's dueling with the noose. All right. What else we got here? Okay, so we got another DS publisher. Roundup? Let's see. Roundup. Number 4, January 1949. Thank you very much. Let me get this off the screen so you get a better look at that.
Oh, man, that's a good one. He's shooting his way out and taking the girl, too.
Oh, yeah. All the covers on this runner. Good girl. I have another one in here somewhere. Let's see where we're at. Oh, we got plenty of time. Okay, I'm going to do one more. I'm going to send you over to Jambo. How about Real Western Adventures with the Masked Ranger, with bondage and the Acme companies involved? No way. Not our beloved Acme company. So we got the Bizarro Lone Ranger right here.
All they need is the Roadrunner in the background there.
We have the Masked Ranger featuring the Crimson Avenger. Dang, we got both of them in there. All right, over to Jambo.
Well, this one is number one. It's got a good girl in it, but I just couldn't resist the...
Yeah.
Galoots.
Oh, dude, I need that.
And there's Wilma hustling with the bad guys.
That's so sweet. I'm getting a cavity in my heart.
Gunslinging Galoots.
Number one.
I like
seen it. You seen it here on Nighttiger Comics.
Bullet-packed Western Adventures.
Let me ask you a question. Everybody out there in YouTube comic book community land, where else are you going to see that book? But Jambo Comics and Nighttiger Comics. Oh, damn. That is nice.
The black.
Joe Manili.
19.
Is that a Joe Manili?
Sid Shores.
Sid Shores. Mm. Sail to the Sid Shores.
Yeah.
That is a killer cover.
He's Shanghai in that girl.
Hey, what number is that? 12? Is that 12?
19.
19. Black Rider number 19. Where's my pen?
No Atlas.
I got to start taking notes.
but Billy West.
Oh, another one. It's Billy West, and what's the other one? I forget.
Bronco Bill.
Yeah, Bronco Bill.
This is an Alex Schomburg, too.
Nice.
Oh, wow.
Standard.
Yes. I think that's above standard to me.
It's pretty fancy.
Wah, wah, wah.
Unfortunately, these Westerns have been going up in price a bit.
One more?
Okay, one more. Oh, that's a great one. Wow. Billy West, number what?
This is number 7 from 19. Billy West. And it's another Alex Schomburg, too.
Wow. Woohoo!
That's what
I'm right.
Coming out of that barn.
We're going to head over to Dave. All right, got this card?
This is an Agni Witten.
Nice. I've been looking for that one, but there's the only one I could find is solo grade. That is a nice cover.
Yes.
She's got the whip going around the title.
Here's another one of those.
Dude, that is amazing.
I like the guy hiding here behind the rock.
I like the stars in the background. You don't see too many covers with that.
Yeah, there's always like on the. There's another one of these where there's another jealous guy. He looks like the same guy.
A stalker or just a bad guy or a jealous guy?
He's a jealous guy.
Oh, yes. Okay. Another tough book to find.
Beauty, man. That's a beauty.
Do you have any of the Soldier of Fortune good girls?
No.
Them are hard to get, too.
And here's one more. Going back to Ring.
Nice. That's I love that cover. It's got just a real strong like action pose.
Yeah, and I like the coloring and the fringe on her dress and the way it was highlighted. Beautiful cover.
I mean, the only other cover you're going to get with that kind of scene would be Tomahawk, and I'd much rather see Fire Hair.
And I have a question mark here. Somebody, it looks like Ed Waldman was maybe the cover artist, but I'm not sure.
I've never heard of him. So he's pretty good. He's pretty good. All right, you got one more?
Do I? Yeah, I can show. Somebody may have already shown this.
Yeah, I did. But that's a great book. That's one I'm always will buy if I can find it at a real good price.
Let me Let me throw one more up. I don't. Maybe it was shown.
Oh yeah. Oh dude, that's nice.
The Skywall books.
Yeah, I didn't. I bet you that book's not hard to get.
Probably now. Yeah, probably not.
Okay, I'm going for that. Okay, over to Nighttigers. Or one. Ah, one Nighttiger. What's up? Okay, Cowpoke, we're going to show some books here. How about Wild Bill Hickok, number 1?
Oh, yeah.
This is a Graham Ingalls cover.
Yeah.
And I've been waiting a long time to wait for this book to come up.
I love the colors on that book, man. That's fancy.
I don't even remember. I didn't even write down what I paid for it.
That's a beauty.
Number 1, September 1949.
Did you get that off of eBay?
Yeah.
Maybe from a seller called Blizzard or?
Yeah, probably.
Okay. Yeah.
I need that.
Yeah, he had some Wild Bill Hickoks that came up, I remember.
Oh, this is one that I check at least once a week.
Yeah.
For listings. I just got this high grade puppy in. Remember Bronco Bill? Well, here he is with his girlfriend. Number 5. It says it's number 1, but it says number 5 on it.
Could be number 1, yeah.
Well, according to Grand Database, December 1949, Bronco Bill. She's right in the center. Well, that's where I want her to be. All right, I'll show one more. This actually was a pickup this year. Wild Bill Pecos, the Westerner, number 28, September
1950. Oh.
And that is Calamity Kate cover by Matt Lear.
Nice. What's a wild Bill Pecos up to there?
Wouldn't you want to be where he's at right now?
Out on the prairie up to no good.
I know. He's got a little prairie dog out. All right. We're going over to Jambo. Who's the publisher? Do you know on this? I don't remember. I got that for $20 even shipped.
I don't remember now.
Nice. Dang, you guys are showing me stuff I haven't seen.
Like he's got olive oil there.
You're going to make me spend money. That's 49. Nice. I like it. Right over the barbed wire fence.
1949.
All right. You can't trust when you can't trust the environments.
Is this the one you showed?
That looks like new. Oh, that's a nice one.
That's one you showed? This number.
No, three. I didn't show that one. That's what I need.
Rescuing the girl there.
I think that's the one you showed, and I went on eBay right away looking. It took me a while to search that out. I found one for 30. It took me like 2 hours of doing different searches.
The cross draw.
It's weird how some books don't come up under a normal search.
Yeah, there's not that many of them, it don't seem like. There's number three.
Nice. And didn't you say you got those for $5?
Yeah, they were like about $5 and $6 a piece.
Wow.
That's some good artwork, too.
That is. That's really good. Max. Let me take Jax and Roy Kirk off there so we can see it proper.
Max Elkin artwork.
Nice.
Number three from
1949. Yahoo! Yeehaw!
One more.
He's another one?
Yeah.
Dude, that's the best one yet.
Four from 1948.
Did you buy them all at the same time or are they different times?
I bought them all at the same time.
Oh, wow.
I seen them and I was like, oh, these got to come with me.
That's right.
So I'd never seen them before, so that's the time to buy them when you've not seen them.
I never seen them until you showed them.
One more. This one is number.
Oh, no. Damn.
There's the girl.
Oh, wow. That's cool.
She's dangling on a rope.
I've got a few of those Western Adventures, but not that one. That is cool. What number is that, Jambo?
I think this one's number six, I believe.
Yeah. Yeah, that's a cool one. I like that.
It is.
So,
That's
it.
All right. We are going over to, is it to me? No, it's a Dave.
Yeah.
All right. Let's see.
All right. I've only got a few more. Then I want to maybe see if somebody knows a picture that I'll show. But anyway, here's one a little bit not politically correct anymore, but that's what's her name? Minnie Chicha or something in the background?
Yeah.
Actually,
I have a few of those pulled out.
The Redskin Riot. Oh, look at the leg on her. Damn. Okay, what number is that?
48.
Ranger Comics.
I don't have written down who the... Is this an Ogden Whitney cover, maybe? That would be my guess.
I don't know, but it looks good. Look at the neck on that horse. It's so perfectly... No, that's another good one. What number is that?
Let's see. Mike, this is number 62.
Nice.
That looks like a Maurice Whitman too. Yeah.
And then one last thing I want to show to see maybe if any of your audience knows what this would be from. I bought this many years ago. And I don't know, the artist is Fred Rhodes, but I don't know what it is to. And this is not a good girl piece, but it's a piece of original art. And it's Christmas, as you can see. But if anybody knows what this goes to, be grateful.
I have no clue.
So anyway, well, that's all I've got, gents.
All right.
Would be something to show to Paulo. I bet he might know.
Yeah, that's a good idea. Maybe on the next Micah stream.
All right. Here we go. All right. excuse me. Here we got a. I gotta get a drink. Another Avon number one, Fighting Indians of the Wild West.
Oh, yeah.
This is March 1952.
No, I got it from my comic shop.
Pretty cover.
Yeah, that's a great one.
I think, I don't know, but I'm guessing it's a Kinstner.
I would say that's a good guess. Yeah, it's a very
nice flames in the background. I love the green behind the title.
That is awesome. Right.
So this next one only counts as one, all right? So back off. Roundup. Number five, March 1949. Another DS publisher book. But I got me a second copy.
You're in nice shape.
So I paid $63 for that one and $51 for this one. I want to keep them off the market and keep the price.
You're cornering all the right market, and the price will go up, right?
I'm going to show one more. This is another DS publishing book. This is Outlaws, number seven from February 1949. I'm always looking for these DS, any of the DS publisher books you want to pick up. They're all top notch. They're kind of semi-scarce. And if you can find them in decent shape for around 30, 40 bucks, I'd pick them up.
I like his hat.
All right, we're going to go over to Jambo. I'm running out quick. I got to slow down on my end. Wow, I didn't think we'd go through them this quick.
All right. How about a...
Nice.
Alex Schomburg.
What number is that? 76?
I don't know. I'll pop it open and we'll find out. How about
that? It's not on the cover?
No.
Oh, because I have one right here. And it has 75 on it.
Let's see.
Imperious Flex says a lot of new eBay save searches.
Yeah.
Number 78.
So, yeah. 78. Okay. That's a very nice cover. I like it a lot. I don't know. I think I used to have that.
And this one, the Wild Bill Hickok.
Oh yeah, nice.
Actually, thought it was dirty, but it's in rough shape, really. But all that stuff around her head is supposed to be dust.
Oh.
Because I looked at other better copies, and I was like, man, is this book that bad? And it's all on there. It's dust.
Just don't feel bad. You could have soaked it and then dried it, put it back on, and go, oh, it's not the cover.
Yeah, nice painted cover, though. It's good artwork.
It is. I love it. I need that one. I'm trying to get all the Wild Bill Good Girl covers.
And another straight arrow.
Oh, there you go. Frazetta?
No, this is Fred Meager.
I like the red dress. It's just so bright. It's almost like Christmassy.
Number 14. It is Christmas. It's getting close to the season, though.
It is. I'm hoping I got time to do a holiday show.
I think it's fall for Christmas. I don't know if that's PC or not. This one's just got a good girl in it. But it's a right fancy Jesse James.
It is. It's Avon, the covers are amazing.
Yeah.
That is a beautiful cover. Look at the composition, how it leans into the center to her and then down.
So
and it has your name on it.
Got my name on it. One more.
Oh, yeah.
B-Barbie Riders.
I'm trying to get 14 like a mad dog.
Oh, yeah.
They just had one on my comic shop, but it was like out of my comfort zone.
Dave's got that. Dave, show that, man. You got that book.
Which one?
14.
The B-Barbie Riders with the horror cover.
Yeah, that's one of my favorites.
That's awesome.
But it's not a Western.
No, yeah, but it is a Western title. Yeah, what are you talking about?
It's a Western theme.
Well, I can probably go get
it. They consider it a horror slash Western, but yeah, he's a cowboy.
I can see if I can grab it real quick. I'll be back.
All right. Jamie, if you wanna go a little bit, go for it, Parv. Go. Because I got like 8 books left. No, I got about 9 or 10.
All right. There's a nice another Avon book.
You know what? That's nice, dude. I need that. I'm trying to get all those in the run. They're hard to get. You don't know. Yeah.
They're not.
You got that in a comic shop, though, right?
Yeah, they're not real pricey, but just finding them is
hard,
you know. And I double up on this one.
Yeah, I think I have that one. Let me see. Yeah. Oh, I don't. I need that one.
I got one here for
you. Here, look. I have this one. We could do a trade, Pard.
We'll swap out. We'll pardon.
We can do a trade. You want to do a trade on that?
Yes, this is number 11.
Yeah, so we'll talk it over.
For you. And I've got probably about 8 more books.
Okay, then hold back. Let's let Dave go.
All right, guys.
You ready? You ready, partner? Yeah. Dave, let's hear. Dave, we got to hear your southern accent.
Hell, I was born out here in Colorado. I don't have a southern accent.
You're a fake one. That's so nice. 7-5. Oh, wow. I know, man. I wanted to get that book someday.
See, he's got his 6-shooter and his cowboy boots.
Yeah. Yeah, I guess you're right. That qualifies. But, and then one more thing I'll show here, and then I'm done. In fact, I got to tap out because I'm going to try to get over to the gym before it closes. But here's
that's nice.
Original art. This is kind of a twice-up page. It's not a good girl, I realize, but... And I've got kind of a whole story. I'm not going to show all pages, but.
Who is that? Who did the work?
I don't know offhand.
That's nice.
I wasn't quite prepared. And let's see, I'll show one more page here.
Wow.
Nice,
I love that,
man. That is awesome.
So, all right.
Very cool, buddy.
All right, well, Jeff, I got to tap out.
All right, well, thank you for coming in. I always enjoy seeing your collection.
You know, the worst thing about the show is I'm going to have to now go back on the rewatch and rewind and with a pen and pencil. And paper and write down a bunch of issues. So if I buy anything, I'll just send you guys the bill if that's okay.
All right. So Dave, before you go, sincere from Nighttiger's heart, you are always, your collection is always an inspiration every time I see it.
Oh, well, thank you.
And I just want you to know that. So yeah.
I don't have a lot of golden age like you do, Mike. I wish I did.
That was amazing.
You know, and when I was younger, heavily collecting when it was affordable, it was mainly Spider-Man, you know, Marvel and Marvel Heroes primarily. So,
I collect that stuff. Show you just one thing. I got to show you this, but just to share with you, I collect everything, but I just got this in for. I've been wanting this book for a while, and I got it at a Raw Pro. It was $100.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Yeah, you had that on your live stream the other, didn't you? Or I
think this book, dude, talk about your Westerns. It's really high grade.
Yeah,
it's,
wow, that is a great one.
October 41. It was $20 on eBay.
Yeah.
That's a beautiful cover.
I'm debating whether to remove this, because this is the post office or whoever put this on. When they shipped it.
Right, right.
And they just split it open. So I don't know if I should leave it as part of the character of the book or remove it for the appearance.
It don't really affect the cover that much, you know.
No, I'd leave it on.
Yeah, I'd probably
part of the history of the book, the way it came.
But just I collect everything. I just got this finally.
Yeah.
One of my favorite Marvel covers.
But my passion is Golden Age. That's my real passion, you know.
Yeah.
But I appreciate it. Like I said, your collection is always an inspiration to me.
Let me show you one other book. I just picked this up yesterday at a local show. In fact, I did, my wife did a video. But
nice. I need
first,
that.
First Super Scroll.
Yeah.
And I got to tell you guys, I don't know if you've noticed this. So we go to this little show here in Denver, and the prices are fabulous right now. I mean, you walk in with some cash and... I think, you know, if you've been, kind of dismayed with the prices from 2021, they're really quite good now. So anyway.
Yeah, the market is really starting to settle and getting amazing deals.
A little bit. Yeah, I'm glad of it too, because everything was really untouchable for a while. Yeah.
Welcome, Joe. Joe from Black Box Silver and Bronze. What's up, partner? Hey.
I have one. I have one that fits your criteria.
And it's probably the best one. Is it the Matt Baker?
I don't know.
Yes, it's the Matt Baker.
Is that Matt Baker?
Yeah, you have the other one with the train in the background.
I can't think of it. That one. Yeah, yeah. But I don't think that has Good Girl on it.
It does. That's a Matt Baker also.
Oh, all right. I'll go grab that one. This is the Texan number 2, St. John.
Yeah, I need that. Yeah. That one's on my radar.
My lighting's not that good here in my office, but
her headlights are lighting everything up.
Yeah, I really like this one. I'll go grab the Texan. Take me off. I'll go grab the Texan.
All right, gents, I'm off.
All right, thank you, Dave. See you later. Have a good night.
Good seeing you, buddy.
All right. I pulled a few more, so I'll show a few.
Okay.
I just got this book. So this is one I also waited and waited until it was under $50. So 36 shipped. Romances of the West. Number 1, November 1949. You know who this is?
No, I don't.
Yvonne DiCarlo.
Is it really? She was a babe in the day.
I know. She was a babe on the Munsters.
Yeah.
My father met her in a restaurant in California.
Nice.
Yeah.
Let me show this one, and then we're going to go. I want to see Joe show his good book. Number 1, Firestar, or Fire Hair. Not the best Good Girl cover, but a Good Girl.
I like it, yeah.
I think this is 1948. Right? Yeah. I have number 1 and number 2. I think I need one more, and I have the whole run.
A good cover.
There's a few two low grade ones I need to replace eventually. All right, let's see what you got, Joe.
All right. I forgot about this one. Yeah. This is
A killer book.
Texan number 8. St. John, 1948, and it is a Matt Baker cover.
He's still in that woman.
Yeah. Oh, that Jamie, that's one of the grails of the Golden Girl Westerns right there.
Yeah.
Look at the train in the background.
Yeah, the colors on here, the flames on the train.
If your lighting was better, that book would be
Let me see if angels. Does this help?
Yes, it does.
There you go.
It does a lot.
All right. I can't keep. Yeah, there. Okay.
Oh, yeah.
That makes it better?
Yes, 100%. Scalp hunters hide their tracks. Ghost riders. What does it say? Ghost riders left the...
Ghost riders defy the range law.
Wow.
I tried to talk him out of that book. He wouldn't budge.
I don't blame him.
Was my other one. I don't know if maybe the colors are better now on...
What did you get that one? Oh, I'm the one that sent him the listing for that, Jambo. I knew that he liked trains, and so I gave it to him.
Oh, man. Yeah.
So that's it, though. That's it.
Those are nice, Joe.
I have the rest of my Good Girl Westerns are either Silver Age or modern. So that's all I can contribute. Now,
that one said Ghost Rider on the cover, and I'm sorry to say I don't have none of the magazine Enterprise Ghost Rider books, because one or two of those have some pretty nice Good Girl artwork on it. Like one when he's in the saloon, I think, is a nice Good Girl cover. And I think there's another one where he's saving a damsel.
I have a couple of Ghost Riders.
Yeah, I didn't pull mine either. I didn't really.
They're very cool.
One's on the wall.
A couple, yes. Well, I mean, that one's got a bad Good Girl down there dressed up in a costume.
I was so happy to get this. This book is just like a ghost.
Yeah, ghost.
I didn't know it existed. And when I saw it, I jumped on it. And I did research to see, you know, sales and all that.
Some of those Ghost Rider, they have the Frazetta covers and they're just impossible to get hold of.
Yeah.
I wouldn't say impossible, but very, very hard.
You can get them if you.
Well, I'm saying you never know. Some guy from a flea market find just post some books. And
it's possible.
Oh, I seen a book, a $400 book the other day on my comic shop. It was $23 and it was already gone.
Oh, wow.
It's called Great I told you about it. Great Comics.
Yeah.
1945.
Yeah.
That's
a lot of times those scarce books, they're so scarce, they're worth a lot. But if they're missing a centerfold, my comic shop lists them for like pennies. It's weird. Well,
we're getting close to Thanksgiving. So what about old Chief Wahoo and Minnie there?
I've never seen that before. That is a good girl.
He's looking
for the. I'm going to be looking for that one. That one, I think, is pretty affordable.
Yeah, most of these are, unless you get like the Buck Rogers. But they're still cool. Still very cool. Here's one more of those.
Oh, dude. Okay, I need the number of that one.
That is number 136 from 1945.
You said 136?
Yeah.
That one's cool.
I like it a lot. Does it have a war bond thing on it too?
Yeah, I think so.
Oh, nice.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. I think that's a book that's
Scarlett O'Neill in it and Buck Rogers and Chief Wahoo.
Okay, Joe, back off. Don't search for that book.
All right, I'll show you one more. This is not the Golden Age, but
Rawhide, oh, Zorro, yeah, Lady Rawhide. I have the mini, I have what is it, the ash can?
Yeah, Fatal Attraction.
Look at okay, so hold on. I just want everyone to know it's an unsanctioned modern comic show. Okay, back to Jambo. Okay, back to Jambo.
I'll show you this one that you've already shown.
Oh, yeah.
Redskin.
Nice. I love that cover.
So I'm going to bring
the Indian looks weird, but I still love that cover. It's one of the best canoe bondage covers over the waterfall that I've seen.
I don't know, I have three, but yeah, it's one of the better ones.
I have three, including that one.
Three of them.
Yeah.
That's more than Golden Age. Yeah. So
one is Nokia, which is actually a pretty good cover too.
Yeah.
And the other one is Foremost. And no, I have four. And then there's another one in Exposed crime cases.
I gave $7 for that. So
nice. Yeah. Oh, that's a good. Anytime I'll find those, I'll buy them. I love them that much. Okay, over to the Nighttiger. What happened to my Southern accent? It's changing to something else. Oh, okay, here we go. How about some Western Love Trails? A completely impossible issue to get. This is not complete. I went ahead and bowed down and got it, but I've been trying to get a complete issue for years.
That's a pretty cover.
There's three issues, two issue ones that are different and an issue two. And this is issue, it says 22, but it's issue two. We have, I don't know if this... We got us a Thrilling Comics number 75. I think this is a Schomburg.
It is an Alex Schomburg, yes, sir.
This is a train cover. Didn't I Oh, Joe's gone. I think I gave Joe one of these or something. I had a second copy. I don't remember. Oh, I gave someone a copy of this or another copy. That is, I can't even tell you. I begged it and boarded it like that. Why? I don't know. Okay, another Annie Oatman.
A good
one. Oh, Joe, did you see me show the Annie Oakley? I got it today.
Yeah, that was really sweet. Yeah.
Joe's the one that turned me on to that listing, that rascally rabbit. I couldn't turn it down.
Over there.
All right, one more. Then we'll head over to you. Oh, man, I was happy to get this one, Jamie. Border Patrol. Number two. With the Good Girl Golden Age Western cover.
Those Border Patrols are hard to find.
Very nice.
That's nice.
August 1957. I need to get number one yet.
Who did that? What
publisher? I don't know. This is another DS publisher. DS. I told you DS has some good titles.
Ah, yeah. I'm making a list, man. My list is getting bigger and bigger.
All right. Joe, you got something else to show, partner?
I have nothing else.
All right. We're going to go over to Jambo.
All right. What about some
nice
spider with some good girl bondage back?
Yep. There. I need that one. I've been looking for it.
Number two from 1950.
That's Youthful Enterprises.
Youthful, yes, sir.
Youthful Magazine. Youthful Magazine. Very nice. They had some good titles too. Yeah. I picked up a couple romance books from them.
That's a pretty cool one. Pretty cool. And everybody's favorite.
Yep. Oh, I didn't pull mine. I don't know why.
Number one. This is A1 122, so I did write that one down.
Nice. Look at her looking at that guy pulling his gun, kicking the other guy.
Face, man. She's quite.
She's like Batgirl of the Wild West.
Yeah. Yeah, she's got it going on there. Frank Bowl art.
Love it. Love it.
Let's try fancy. So. This is not Golden Age, but it's Golden Age stories.
That counts. That definitely counts. Wow, look at her front.
Yes,
that looks weird.
But that looks weird.
That looks really weird.
Number two.
Whoa. Are these just reprints?
Yeah, they reprinted some of her stories and stuff inside.
That's a good cover.
And Red Mask also. But nobody cares about Red Mask.
That's right. Get him out of here. We just care about Black Phantom.
All right. One more of the Black Phantom.
Nice.
Number 25.
Yeah, they have one on eBay for $99 right now. And another one for $199.
Yeah. Frank Bowl and Dick Ayers' Ghost Rider story inside here too.
Oh, you're trying to sway me into buying it, huh?
Yeah,
I want it. It's one that I'm gonna have eventually. I think I'm waiting for a better copy at a better price.
Yeah, this one's not the best, but hey, it's there.
Yep, that's what counts.
She's got the thin waistline too.
Oh yeah, she put that belt on just a little bit too tight. All right, you gonna go? Okay, over to me. Over to Nighttiger. Here we go, Pards. Okay, so. More Avon. They have a ton of Good Girl covers in several Western books. This is Wild Hickok, number 13. Did you show this one?
No. I don't have that one.
Bloody Canyon Massacre. She's got a torn skirt, guys. May 1952. Don't know who does the cover offhand, but and then we got Tim Tyler the Cowboy. This book was $6 on eBay.
Wow.
And it's pretty high grade too.
Yeah. For $6, heck yeah.
That was where I got that other one, Bronco Bill, I think it was.
Yeah.
So, yeah, that's. I think this was a good buy. I really like that cover. It's more subtle, but it's pretty cool. All right. What do we got here? What do we got? How about another DS publisher? We got another issue of Roundup. Number 3, May 1940. There's 5 issues in this run.
Right.
I just love the graphics on here. Mystery of the Mammoth Mesa. Ranger Recruit. Saga of Mexican Mike.
Nice.
All right. You got more?
I've got not really much more.
I got 4. We're close. We're doing good.
I got 1 or 2 more. This one's a Foremost, and it's nice. An L.B. Cole.
Oh, that is nice. What number is that? Oh, those numbering on those are hard.
Volume 7, number 4.
Volume 7, number
4. 1948. And this one is not a comic, but... it is Good Girl.
Oh, yeah.
Golden Age Frontier stuff from 1948, I think.
Well, one thing's for sure, that is a good girl. And they're doing bad
stuff. Killing her out of the back of the wagon.
Hey, that's a good cover. I love it.
So,
man, it was nice back in the day when painted covers were like affordable.
Yeah.
Enough to, you know, for them to hire artists to do painted covers for comic books. Now they can't afford to do that. They do one image. They'll paint one image and then they'll copy it and paste it on different covers.
Blow it up.
All right. So we're in the home stretch. I hope all you little cowpokes out there enjoyed this, saw something you never saw before, feel inspired maybe to dip your toe into the river of Golden Age comic books. Check it out. You know, and we didn't touch on this a lot, but these are super fun to read. I enjoy immensely, and you'll get a whole lot more out of one of these comics than you will out of one modern comic. It's not even a close match. So with that, I got 4 books left, and then we're going to say our goodbyes to everybody. Dang, I should have done a Beverly Hillbillies like exit video. Okay, here we go. So I got a Brick Bradford. I think you have this.
I think I do, yes. I think I have that one somewhere. I didn't pull it. Yeah.
Number 7. I'm sure it's like 1948 or 49.
Yeah.
Brick Bradford.
Another title that kind of switched backwards and forwards, you know.
Yeah, it has some sci-fi ones that are.
Sometimes, and then sometimes adventure, and then. Cowboy stuff when that got big. You know?
It has like what number 2 is the robot cover and it's worth a couple $1,000.
Yeah, that's the one that everybody looks for.
Okay, so this book is an EC book. So before your crime titles really got popular, they had a couple Western kind of romance Western that didn't run very long, but they ran before the crime comics. So you got Real Stories, Official Records, Saddle Justice. This is the last issue. Graham Ingalls, September 1948. I'm always hunting. I'm always looking for these. They haven't been too prominent lately, but last year I found like 3 or 4.
Yeah.
And then another one I'm always hunting for. Do you have one of these? I think you do, don't you? Western Crime Busters.
I don't have that one. No, I don't have that one.
But you have one of the issues.
Yeah, I've got 1 or 2 of those, I think.
This is number 10 from April 1952.
Yes.
And every one of these covers has a Good Girl cover to it, I believe. So we'll end with checking out a couple of these. Let's see what we see here. L switch backwards. Erds for words. Okay. With that, the last book to show in this video. Thank you everyone that supported this video, came in the chat. If you're watching this on the replay and you get this far, immensely appreciated that. This is an EC book. It's another Western title. Like I was saying, they preceded the crime books. So here's from 1950, Gunfighter, number 14, March 1950. This is the last issue also of this run.
That might be my favorite yet.
She got some perky little mm-mms there.
Yeah.
The buckskin kid.
He's right fancy.
I didn't put, who did this? I didn't research who did this cover. Oh, it's Johnny Craig. Hello. Look how she's leaning up and tied up near the TNT. It's a really great cover.
That's beautiful.
These aren't really super scarce. They can be found not easy, but they're out there.
They're out there, but they're out there with a nice price tag too.
This one I paid less than 100.
Really?
Or no, 109. But I think most of them have gotten around $50.
That's a good buy on that.
Yeah, that's why I bought it. I mean, I rarely will buy something I don't feel comfortable. You know what I'm saying?
Yes.
Unless that's why I don't do auctions anymore, because I get in revenge bids. And I hate it. And I hate myself for days.
You can't have that. I want that.
No. I know. You just get caught up. You're like, okay, I'll do $2 more. Yeah. All right, 4. All right, 10's the limit. Before you know it, you're like twice what you wanted to pay.
I never win on eBay. Everybody always does those Skype bids. They have an automatic program or something like that that Skypes in the last second. You think you've won it, and it says you've won it. And all of a sudden you did win it because somebody Skyped you with that program or something.
Yeah, I've had that happen before.
Yeah.
But I've won a few good ones. But the only thing is, to win those few good ones, you got to go through stress of maybe another 75% bad ones just to get those few good ones. Right. It's not worth it to me. I'll stick with buy it now, negotiate. Let me see.
It's a lot less stressful, buy it now. Yeah. I do like it better now.
So on this book, I just got for $140 before shipping.
Oh, yeah.
But they had $190 on it.
Right.
Okay. They had $190. I offered them $140. They came back with $160, and I declined. And right. I left them a little message. I said, thank you for negotiating with me. Or counter, whatever. I said, but I don't feel comfortable paying more than $140 for, I forget why I said. And the next day I got an email. Okay, we'll take $140. I'm like, okay. And then I got this dude.
Oh, that's cool.
This was another one that I offered them, like I lowballed, and they came back. And I left him a message again telling him I didn't feel comfortable because it was such a low grade. And they took my first offer.
He was only in, what, 2 or 3 of those, Marvel Boy?
4.
4 of them?
Yeah. But the cool thing is the first 2 issues are Marvel Man. Let me see where we're at if we're supposed to be in. We got 2 minutes. The first 2 issues are Marvel Man. The next 2 issues are Astonishing. But there's Canadian prints where the 3 and 4 are still called Marvel Boy, and they have them on the cover, but they have reprints of Fox Jungle Books inside.
That's weird.
Yeah, but they're so scarce.
That would be something, yeah, I'd really want.
Because the covers are original, too. Yeah, it's weird, because I got number 2, which is 4. I don't remember the numbering's weird. For like $80 last year. Which is cheap. It's like a $400 book. So I started researching the whole run because there's only 4 issues.
Right.
And I started finding out that there was Canadian prints and all this. What do they look like and all that? It's really fascinating. Anyways, we got to wrap it up. Jambo Comics.
Yeah.
Thanks for coming on and showing your awesome, good. Western Good Girl Collection.
I want to thank all them gunslinging galoots in the chat also that stopped by. I really appreciate it. And I was happy to be on here. Look at all these fine Western books.
It was a lot funner than I imagined it was going to be, partner there. Pilgrim.
Pilgrim.
But yeah, I had a great time. I know.
That's kind of sacrilegious, isn't it?
What is?
You should have showed some John Wayne.
Oh, I don't have any.
I've got one or two, but they don't have any good girl on them.
Right, yeah.
Punching somebody or shooting somebody.
All right, all you rascally varmints out there. It was definitely fun. You know, I would like to do another thing, maybe do this like twice a year with different, like we could do crime next time or jungle, of course. And you know,
well, I'm all about that.
Yeah. So maybe let's do jungle next, maybe sometime in April or something.
Sounds good.
And we'll come up, let's come up with a name and we'll do, it'll be like a biannual show.
Yeah.
Sounds good. I'll get with you on that. Bungling. Anyways, it was a great turnout. We had, I think, 17 at the peak or something like that.
Awesome.
So not bad. Roger's going to be starting his show in about 14 minutes, so we want to get out of here. So again, thank everybody. Thank you, everybody. Thank Joe. Thank Dave from Spinner Rack. Jambo. All right, we're out of here.
Nighttiger, peace out.